Hello everyone, I am Akshay and in this video we'll cover call, apply and bind methods in JavaScript. I would suggest you to open your console and start coding right away along with me. So without wasting any time, let's dive into the code.
Let's take an object name which has two properties. First name and a last name. And it also has a method print full name . This method prints the full name in the console . So how would we print that in console . So console.log . So first of all, let me tell you, like, each and every function in JavaScript has access to a this keyword over here in this function, that this keyword will point to the name object. So over here, if we do console.log this.firstname plus a space and a this.lastname. So this first name and last name will be these first name and last names. So over here, the this refers to the name object. This is our print full name method, which prints the full name on console. And how to invoke this method? Yeah, it's simple. Name dot print full name. So let's check how this runs on browser. So yes, see, the full name is printed on browser now. So that's simple. So suppose if we had one more object, which is name two, which again had two properties, first name and last name. So first name, let's take it as Sachin Tendulkar. And last name, Tendulkar. Okay. And if we had to print this name as well, so one method could be to copy this print full name inside this name to object. But that's obviously not a good way to do it. So that's where call method comes into picture. Using call method, we can do a function borrowing. So this concept is known as function borrowing. We can borrow functions from other objects and use it with the data of some other objects. So let's take an example and look how we can do that. So first of all, take the function which needs to be called, which is name.printfulName in our case. And each and every method in JavaScript has access to this special function, which is call. In this call, the first argument will be the reference, or in simple terms, like what we want this to be pointing to. So we want this to be pointing to the name to object in our case. So we will pass name to as the first argument. So if we do something like name.printfulName and a dot call method along with where our this needs to be pointed to. So over here, name to. And let's check what it prints on the console now. So it prints Sachin Tendulkar. And it is quite useful. Like, we can borrow functions from other methods, and that's how we do it. However, in general case, we don't keep our methods inside these objects like this if we want to reuse them. Rather, we just take them off and keep it somewhere outside like this. So we have a separate method, print full name, and according to our need, we can use it over other objects by using a call method and passing the reference over here. So instead of name.printfulName, now we can just do a printfulName.call and we can pass in name over here. Similarly, in the second example, we can do something like printfulName.call and then name to. So let's save our file, clear the console and run this again. So if we run this again, see, again we got the same result what we were getting previously. What if we had more parameters into this function? So suppose we had something known as hometown, or hometown also inside this, and we want to print something like first name plus last name plus from and then the hometown. Okay, so we have one more parameter as hometown over here, and we want to print it like this. So how we will pass different parameters inside this function is, the first parameter will always be the reference to the, this variable, and the later arguments can be the arguments to the function. So suppose if I have this hometown over here, so I will be passing hometown as the second argument over here. So we got this output where we got the hometown as well. So over here, this is undefined because we didn't pass anything. Let's pass over here Mumbai, and now it should be fine. So suppose our printfulName method had more arguments. Along with hometown, we also had a state, and we had to print something like hometown plus state. So what we would have done is, we would have passed a state argument over here. So let's check it how it runs. Okay, so we should pass over here also Rashtra. And if we had more than these arguments, then we could have just comma separated and passed over here. So now let's talk about the apply method. The only difference between the call and apply method is the way we pass arguments. Let's see how that works. Instead of call, we had apply over here. So the way we pass arguments over here is, the first argument is again the reference to the this variable, and the second argument is list to the arguments what we have to pass in the function. So instead of passing these arguments individually in the call method, in apply method we pass these arguments in a array list. That's it. So let's run and check this. So that's how we do it. So again, to recap, in call method we will pass these arguments individually, comma separated, and in the apply method we will pass it as a second argument as an array list. So let's come on to the bind method. The bind method looks exactly the same as the call method, but the only difference is, instead of directly calling this method over here, the bind method binds this method printfulName with an object and returns us the copy of that method. Let's see how it does that. Print my name and printfulName.call. Instead of call, we had a bind. So what it will do is, it will create a copy of printfulName, and it will bind that to name to object and will return a function. So there's a catch over here, that it doesn't directly calls that method like we called it directly and prints it to the console. Rather than, this will return us a method which can be called later. So we can see that by logging this print my name method onto the console. So over here, if we print this into the console, see, this is a function. This is a function which can be invoked later. So if we had to invoke this method, so we can directly just invoke it like a normal method. So see, we got this result over here. So this is basically used to just bind and keep a copy of that method and use it later. The only difference between call and bind is, like, it gives you the copy but which can be invoked later, rather than directly invoking it wherever we are writing this line of code. So this is all about call, apply and bind. So let's recap it quickly. So we have a call method which is used to invoke a function directly by passing in the reference which points to this variable inside the method. Apply is exactly same as the call method. The only difference is, it takes the second argument as an array list of the parameter which needs to be passed to this printfulName function. And similarly, bind method does not directly invokes the method but gives you the copy of that exactly same method which can be invoked later. That's all for call, apply and bind.
These functions are quite common in interviews just because they are origin to a lot of other concepts in JavaScript. So generally, interviewers first ask you about call, apply and bind methods, and then immediately after that, they will ask you to write the polyfill for a bind or function currying or other similar concepts in JavaScript which are directly related to these functions. These questions are frequently asked by companies for front-end roles, and these are very important topics. In my next videos, I'll be covering all these topics, function currying, polyfill for bind, and a lot of things. So subscribe to my channel and keep watching these videos and stay up to date. And also like the video if you really liked it. A lot of cool stuff is coming up. If you have any suggestions in mind, or if you want me to cover any specific topic or any specific question, then feel free to message me on Facebook, LinkedIn, or just drop a comment down below and I would be happy to help you. So that's all for now. Thanks for watching.